lemonade. I'm going to
get Bob's lemonade. I'm good. Bob, doing a little bit of primer in here.
Yeah.
Is this a Casitas?
Scamp.
Oh, Scamp. Okay.
74 Scamp.
74 Scamp. Getting it ready for paint. There's already primering it. Can't get too close. We'll end up painting on the lens. What do you think, Tabby? Here's another trailer that Bob's reskinning. And just to show you, because my DeVille is behind right now in work, I've been dealing with hospital issues. But here's one that Bob's working on. He's completely reskinned the interior. And they're all the same, pretty much. All require the same amount of work. He's completely redone the inside, all the walls. And it's interesting to note here where he's rebuilt the corner edge, he uses plywood and slices the plywood so that it'll bend. That's one way of doing it. I'll be showing you how I do it too. I might even revert to this way. It looks pretty good. Yeah. So, as you can see, just a matter of putting the plywood in there, stapling it in. Of course, you can see the marks that he made here where the window slats go. You can see them here too. Now, he changed it. And he's putting new metal skin on the back, so it doesn't matter. The old metal skin was dinged up and he didn't want to put it back on, so it doesn't matter that his window's in a different place. On the DeVille, we marked this so that all the slats go in the same place. And the insulation goes back on top and the metal skin back over that when he gets done with it, when he gets done building all this back up, this corner. Okay. Oh yeah. This has all been rewired for 12 volts only because they're going to use a voltage converter which converts 110 to 12 volts. Seems to be the way all the newer trailers are going these days. But look how beautiful this is with all new paneling. It's like a brand new trailer in here. Smells new too.
Yeah, it does.
Smells good. It's got this beautiful round wood on the radiused veneer on the corners like the DeVille. Looks really neat. So somebody's going to get a really nice trailer.
The dummy in the window.
Yeah. If we put coins in, do you read our, do you give us our future? Or?
She's going to re-strip all the cabinetry herself.
Oh, really? Oh, okay. So you don't even have to do that.
She's already got all the covered
drawers.
Otherwise,
we'd just hand them before we put them in.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah,
this is just looking great.
Stain them before they go up.
Is this the old GIMP?
That's a new GIMP.
No,
this
new
is GIMP. New, okay. Brand new GIMP.
The old GIMP was too rotten to use.
Yeah, okay. And is this the rubber kind, or is this...
That's the same as you have.
The same I have, okay.
And I'm trying to find more, because I've got to buy up all I can buy now.
Oh, okay.
I used up my whole roll already.
Oh, well, I've got more if you want some.
Roll it up here. I had to drill a little tiny hole first.
Here's how you cover up the seams. You just cut another strip of paneling. It goes right over it. And that's the way they did it at the factory. See? Right there. You put it in with screws. Of course, the seams are all where the slats are on the outside. So. But this is just great. Now you can see the seam in here. That'll get covered.
Here's the old one.
And here it is. Here's the old seam covers. See, they're just same thing. These are beveled, but it's just another piece of paneling. That's all it is.
They're just nailed in.
These are nailed in. He screws his in, so they're not going to kind of go anywhere. This is always a good thing to do. This is the way the factory does it, to connect the pieces. you can see when you put the, just the way it came apart, when you put the metal back on, you staple it to the wood framing with little U staples. I'll have to borrow Bob's gun to do mine.
Now, over here. Over here, we have to put this piece on here because underneath it is the gas pipe to the lantern.
Oh, yeah.
And it has to be covered so that it, because we have to slot through the wood and then lay this right down as it goes down into the tread and then around and underneath.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
That's the way the factory does it, but some factories don't put aluminum over there to protect it from rubbing on the front.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, and you'd want to do that.
Because these keep trailers protected. Do flex going down the road.
Yes,
they don't
do.
Sit still.
They're designed that way. There you go. Work of art in progress.
Yeah, it's come along.
Bob and Cindy Ross.
The Bob Meister.
Bob Meister, yeah.
And I added this piece of wood here. It wasn't one there. But we'll reinforce it when I screw to it.
Yeah, I'm doing the same
There's
thing.
There's also going to be another one.
Yeah, the wind just tends to push this area in. I'm surprised they weren't built with
it. You'll find that done up here, too.
Same thing up here, yeah. So.
That's natural.
Yeah, so the wind tends to push that in, so you might, when you got the skin off, you might want to add some reinforcement, you know, some extra pieces like this. And I think the DeVille has this piece down here, but it doesn't have them, my Westerner doesn't have them up here.
No, this one didn't.
And that's where it's caved in.
But where the cabinet's right here, so
yeah.
there's one in here.
You got one there, yeah. Okay. Great. Yep. Not a lot to it, really, other than just a whole lot of hard work.